when you're having a dialogue with the students is when they actually start to process, because they're put on the spot, they need to respond in real time. And if I can make that exciting and they're thinking on their own, they're going to learn. The name of this course is Electrical Circuits, taught in all engineering programs to sophomore level students. Traditionally, it's been taught in large lecture format, so we could have 200 students sitting in a lecture. Whenever I can, I try and engage the students in solving the problems themselves. And I first discovered how effective that could be when I was teaching large classes and I would offer review sessions. And during the review sessions, the students were directing the discussion to things that they really wanted to know about. And then as we were going through the problems, I'd ask them to provide the key steps, and we discussed those. And pretty soon it became quite the dialogue. The idea is, if I could create that in a classroom where I could get everybody engaged, it's a lot more effective way to learn. So this is how the class works. Prior to class, students get the background that they need to complete the classwork. That could include lectures, practice problems, tutorials, short problem-solving videos. Then they come to class with that background, and then I can give them a 10-minute mini-lecture review of what they need to know to cover the topic. And then for the remainder of the class, the students work 4 to 5 problems that are delivered by an online homework platform. They are allowed to answer 3 times before they lose credit. The questions give feedback immediately so that they know when they're in trouble. And the idea there is that they'll immediately learn if they're doing something wrong so that they'll ask questions. Every student sees slightly different numbers. The answers aren't the same, but the questions that they're addressing are the same. When the student gets stuck, they can't just ask for the answer from the neighbor. They have to ask their neighbor, "How did you get your answer?" Or the neighbor has to show them. And in any case, they're focusing on the solution process. Early in the class, if students misunderstand, they don't realize that that's part of the learning process. All they see is the fact that they're not succeeding the first time, not recognizing that in not succeeding, they're asking questions in the moment and getting answers that will help them never to make the same mistake again. So early results from the studies we've done in this classroom compared to conventional lecture classes have suggested that students are more engaged. They feel more satisfied with the class. They tend to feel much more comfortable taking exams because they've worked hundreds more problems, and they score higher on average. For the same subject, they're more satisfied, and most interesting, they report spending less time out of class preparing for better performance. The scholarship of teaching and learning is helping me to try things, be willing to try things. So how this might apply to other disciplines, the big takeaways: the space is important. When you walk into an active learning space, such as our tile classrooms, the tables are round. That tells the students something's going to be different in this classroom from the time that they walk in. What's essential? Foster discussion about process as opposed to simply answers. And you do that by giving people a common question. So the next key is that when you present whatever it is that you're presenting to the groups, each student should have a different piece. Everybody gets a slightly different problem, but there's enough commonality that they can share their insights and build a collective vision towards, we can all get a good grade if we all work together and this is going to be fun. So I think you can set that up in any class. So in that moment, they're ready to learn. And that's what's very interesting about this approach. They get immediate feedback. They can turn to their neighbor and get instantaneous help from someone working on the same problem, so it's fixed and it sticks because they have an aha moment.